Hey guys, and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm inside new Dacia Duster 2022 model, the brand new Duster, and one of the big changes are our multimedia system. And in this video I will review the multimedia system, I will show you all the information about the multimedia system, also I will show you the cockpit. But the cockpit is actually the classic one, the oldest one, but the multimedia system is the newest one, and it's really good. It's the same multimedia system that the Dacia use also on Sandero and on the other new models. So yeah, let's go guys, let me show you. Also I will make a special video, separate video, with how to connect your phone, your Android phone, to the multimedia system wireless, because this system has a wireless function, so you don't have to use the cable. But it still have cable here, you can see, to charge your phone or also to connect to the media. And also it has a 12 volt port down here, and here is the space. But yeah, I will do also the review. If you want to see the full review with this new Dacia Duster, check it out on the channel. Now here in the front, actually cockpit is the same cockpit as before. It has some information on the display, a digital display in the middle, but on the side it's still the classic view as usually uses with. And then you can change the different function from here, you can see different information, tire pressure and stuff like that, also the range, the consumption, and all kind of information. You have it right there on the screen. Also in the middle you have the two-wheel drive lock, and also lock and auto mode. Good. Anyway, let's go to the multimedia guys. Also, by the way, the car come with this new vents system that it's work really good, and I like it, quite good quality. Then you have some buttons here for eco mode, for example, and the cameras in the back. If you see, the car come with cameras on the rear, and also you can change the view. And I like very much this new screen because it looks a little bit bigger and you have a better visibility. Also the car come with cameras on the side and also in the front, so it's impressive. It's kind of a 360 degrees camera. And yeah, great job. I didn't expect to find a 360 degrees on a Dacia, but still pretty good job. Also you can change the different functions from here, it's pretty cool. So also here you have those function buttons that you can change and adjust different things, but all about that in the other video guys, in the review video. Anyway, in this video it's all about multimedia system. This is the main screen. If you want to go forward, this is a touch screen. By the way, you have pretty good visibility from the driver point of view, so you can change here, you can reach it pretty easy. You can see the information here on the side. Then if you want to turn it on, you have to press the turn on button. Then you have here shortcut buttons that get you in different function. For example, is the volume of the radio, here is the home, here is the settings of the car, it gets you directly to the settings, and here you can close it. Let's go first of all on the home screen. Here on the home screen, it's not a glossy screen guys, it's somehow a combination between glossy and matte, but it is very responsive, and also the colors look pretty okay. And you have the radio, of course, here, very simple. What I like about this multimedia system, what I notice, is that it's pretty responsive. So every time you go into a menu, it's quite responsive, so you don't have to wait too much time for it to go in different function. Then you have the media, no media connected, for music and stuff like that. Then you have the phone, you have to connect your phone. It's very simple. I will make a separate video on how to connect your phone and how it works Android Auto on the car. Then you go to vehicle. Here on the vehicle you have vehicle settings. On the vehicle settings you have all kinds of settings, for example, auto door lock when driving, closing, approach, unlocking, walk away, closing sound. So you can also change different function from here, very simple. If you go back, then you have the driving echo, where you can see different information about the way you drive. It gives you some tips, it shows you the consumption right here. You can also reset it if you want to. And then you have the echo coaching here, it will teach you how to drive economical, so you have some tips here. Yeah, pretty interesting. And then the four-wheel drive 404 infos, here you have all kind of information about the four-wheel drive system, so you can see the position of the car. Then you have the altimeter here, you can see the altitude, where the car it is right now, where it was the car before. It's quite interesting, quite cool information. Inclinometer, this is the name of it. Interesting. Then go back, you have the navigation system here, I will show you in a second. Navigation also is pretty big, don't know if you can see it in the video, guys, but from here, from the driver point of view, you can notice that it's quite big. You have a good visibility there. Also, it's bright, it's nice. You see really well everything there. In terms of responsiveness, don't expect to be something crazy. I mean, it still have a little bit of lag, but once you're setting a destination, for example here, you go okay, calculate the route, it's working pretty fast. I mean, it's calculating the route relatively fast, and here you can see the direction, you can see all kind of information. He's doing his job just perfectly. Don't expect to see something crazy, but in terms of practicality, it's really, really good. Here is the route, option of the navigation. You can change a lot of things, the traffic, destination, and stuff like that. Anyway, this is the navigation. Going forward, smartphone integration. That's something that I will show you in a separate video, guys, because I need more time for it. And actually, from here, you can connect your Android or Apple phone wireless, and you can see all that functions. But check out the other video. If it's not already on my channel, click the subscribe button to see when that video will come out. And then you have the settings. On the settings, you have all the important settings, for example, the volume on the audio, display, brightness, day, night, device information. Here you can see the Wi-Fi options. Here you can turn it on, turn it off, you can choose the language and frequency, the Bluetooth option, and the device management, where you connect your phone. Also, you can connect it from here, and then you go to system, where it's also information, very useful information. You can change the language to the multimedia system here, the clock and units, for example. You can have it in temperature, time format, time settings, navigation, on, off, and system version. It's a pretty simple system. It's very responsive, simple, and it works perfect. And in my opinion, guys, my recommendation is to use it with Android Auto or with your iPhone, because it will make a lot of sense to have all that function and connectivity to the internet on the car. But the screen, the size of the screen, it's perfect. It's the way it should be. It's very responsive. It works really fast. Yeah, a little bit delay here in the navigation, but I guess it's normal for this price. Good, guys, that was the video. I hope you get some useful information from here. If you have questions, ask me down below, whatever you want to ask. In my opinion, for the price range where the Dacia Duster is, I think the multimedia is great. Practicality is here, and for daily uses, you don't need more than that. It's just perfect. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you want to see the other video with Android phone connectivity through wireless, I will have a separate video. Check it out. Probably it's on my channel. If it's not already on my channel, it will come soon. So click the subscribe button to see the notification when the video will come out. Thank you for watching. Stay safe. And also, I will have the review with this new Dacia Duster and the test drive. So, guys, stay safe and see you soon in the next one. Bye.